Tonight, a disturbing new report showing 60,000 dogs are being used every year for animal testing. An undercover investigation by the Humane Society says it found beagles and hounds were used for toxic tests in Michigan. Those experiments lasted for 100 days. All of the animals were destroyed.
The tests were done at the Charles River Lab near Pawpaw, just southwest of Kalamazoo. 7 Action News reporter Brian Abel joins us live from the newsroom with more on this investigation. Pretty big, Brian.
Yes, it is. Now, the tests were being done on behalf of Dow Chemical in Midland, Michigan. They found 36 beagles subjected to toxicity testing that the Humane Society says is completely unnecessary.
These are the disturbing images inside Charles River Laboratories over the course of nearly 100 days, taken by an undercover investigator with the Humane Society of the U.S. It shows dogs, mainly beagles, who are subjects of toxicity testing for pesticides,
which involves force-feeding beagles pesticide every day for a year.
36 beagles, part of the study, according to the Humane Society. While the U.S. has eliminated this type of testing, other countries have not. Dow Chemicals, who commissioned it, says in a statement that it's been working closely with the Humane Society for many months to encourage Brazil's Anvisa to amend its animal test requirements for pesticides, and once given certainty that the study is no longer required, will stop the study immediately. But the Humane Society says Dow has already received confirmation after the Humane Society reached out.
We swiftly reached out to them and said, we have found that there are dogs being used potentially for your regulatory requirement. Is this in fact still necessary in Brazil to get a pesticide approved? We got confirmation that in fact it is not necessary.
Now, the Humane Society says none of this is illegal and happens to 60,000 dogs in labs across the country each year. They are hoping the public pressure will help stop the experiments and save the 36 beagles who are scheduled to be euthanized in July. Now, we did reach out to Charles River Labs and have not yet heard back from them. Reporting live in the newsroom, Brian Abel, 7 Action News.
Tough to see, Brian. Thank you so much.